My name is Donna Friedman, and these days I paint a lot, and I also do work with the International Fourth World Movement, and I'm on the board, I'm a board member of a nonprofit called Project Hope, which is in Dorchester. And I do a lot of hiking and Tai Chi and yoga and lots of other things that make my soul happy. I grew up in Ohio, in the Midwest, Ohio, Indiana, Illinois, and Kentucky. And when I left home, I joined a group that worked in Appalachia. So in my 20s, I was in Appalachia, Big Stone Gap, Virginia, where the tip of Kentucky, Tennessee, and Virginia meet. And from there, I worked in Nashville in a school serving families whose kids had emotional issues that caused them to be thrown out of school. In the Boston area most recently, after getting a PhD in social policy, I joined the Center for Social Policy at UMass Boston. It's part of the McCormick Graduate School, and I directed a research center there for 18 or so years. I stepped down from that work at the end of December 2014. In my 20s, painting, the way that painting has come into my life, starts pretty early. In my 20s, I made a choice to go down the human service career route versus an art career. And I'm glad I made that choice. The experiences I've had over these last 50 years are quite amazing and important, and I think inform my painting. But I kind of dabbled in painting and sketching until I went back to graduate school, and then stopped painting and altogether for 25 years. About a year after I left my full-time position at UMass Boston, I was having coffee with a friend who said she was taking an art class, and I then remembered that I loved to draw and paint, but I hadn't actually allowed myself to go there until that point. I started then taking classes, and I have not stopped since. For this exhibit, I needed to find what is the thread that cuts across all of my paintings, and name the exhibit. And I'm going to share with you an excerpt of a poem that is very important to me, written by Mary Oliver. It's called Messenger. And I hope I get the words right. My boots are old, my coat is torn, I'm no longer young and still not half perfect. Let me keep my mind on what matters, which is my work, which is mostly standing still and learning to be astonished. And I think those words have inspired me over a long period of time, but when I realized what I'm drawn to paint, I'm astonished by the beauty of nature. I'm astonished by just looking around my house and looking at a piece of pottery, or looking at a beautiful piece of fruit, or a plant that keeps coming back. I have an orchid plant that is coming back for the fifth time. I had to paint that plant. Or the people who are part of my life, who I love, and the moments that I have with those persons whom I love. I'm drawn to painting those kinds of images. And the process of painting itself feeds my soul. The first class I took was a watercolor class, which I fell in love with. And I've been continuing with watercolor and pen. And I find that that medium is very, very, allows a lot of expressiveness. It's also very portable. So I bring my watercolors and sketch pad on when I travel, and I paint on planes. It's also a medium that works for where I live. I have a space that I've created in our house that's kind of an art nook. And so it's very easy to just jump into a painting in the middle of the day, go back to it later the next day, and have it be so easy. The name of the exhibit is Awe, and the definition of awe in the dictionary is reverential respect mixed with wonder. And I think that does capture what's behind the paintings that are in the exhibit. There are paintings of places that I've been, special places, sacred places, paintings of people whom I love, paintings of treasured objects, plants, and other forms of nature that are right in my house, and paintings of nature that are very nearby here in the Boston area, particularly the Arnold Arboretum. The painting that's in the exhibit from the Arnold Arboretum, there are actually two of them, but one of them is a paper bark maple. And it's, I think, one of the most beautiful trees in the world. It exfoliates, and it has a shininess about it when it is peeling, when the bark is peeling off. I came to know this tree through my husband, who is a nature guide at the Arnold Arboretum, leading one of the volunteers who leads school groups of kids. And so when we go to the Arboretum, now I'm really noticing the bark on trees. Just quite beautiful. Over the last 25 to 30 years, my family and I have gone to national parks a lot in the Southwest. One of my favorites is the Mesa Verde National Park, where there are cliff dwellings still present in the cliffs, created the footprint of ancient peoples who lived in those cliffs. And they're very mysterious, sacred places. One of my paintings represents one of those sacred places, including a ladder going into a kiva, which was a worshiping center for the ancient peoples when they lived there. My friend Susie is somebody I've known for about a decade, and she is a long-term member of the Volunteer Corps of the International Fourth World Movement. And she is perhaps the best listener I've ever experienced. She's a dear friend. I am working with her and others on several projects right now, some of which are happening in different parts of the world. But I was having lunch with Susie about a week ago, and or recently, and her eyes were sparkling. She was just a picture of color, and she allowed me to take a number of photos of her, and then I came home and then created this painting, which she has allowed me to put into the exhibit. It will then be a gift to her at a later point. This is my first exhibit, and I'm stunned that I'm actually having an exhibit. I really didn't expect that this would be, that painting would be so central to my life when I stepped down from my full-time position, which is sometimes called retirement. But I have to say, I don't feel retired. I feel like, I've stepped into a new phase of life that's really wonderful. That wasn't possible when I was working 60 to 70 hours a week. But I know that those 50 years of work, which was so meaningful to me, really inform, I think, my sense of gratitude for the beauty in the world, for the beauty in the people with whom I'm so close, and especially in these times when there is so much hardship that we all see all the time. I find that I am very drawn to paint beauty. A friend of mine told me that she had an aunt who had dementia. And the only things, events that her aunt talks about are what really were the sparkling moments in her life. And I think that's a very powerful thought. If you had nothing else, what would those sparkling moments be? And for me, what I'm drawn to paint is all about those sparkling moments. What I hope that people will experience, one, an awakening, that we and they see the beauty that's in each other and the beauty that is all around us, just waiting to be noticed. And secondly, I mean, I think this journey that I'm on is testimony to what's possible, that who would have thought, you know. And so I hope that people who come to the reception or see the exhibit give themselves permission to follow their heart and wherever it takes them. It's a fruitful avenue to go down. I know that, and I hope that for that for other people. The opening reception will be on June 3rd from 1:30 to 2:30. And I hope it will be, you know, a very warm community celebration. Art is good just in and of itself without accomplishing anything. I've come to believe that, and I've known that my whole life. But I do, you know, partly because of the ways in which I've invested my life in the world of nonprofits, hoping for a better world near and far, I hope that my art can be used in some ways that benefit the nonprofits I'm connected to, for example, being a board member of Project Hope, being connected to an organization called the New Start Project, connected to the International Fourth World Movement. I've made a decision that if I sell any paintings, the proceeds will go to those organizations that I'm connected with. Also, I'm thinking about, and I've begun a series of portraits that I'm calling Agents of Change or Faces of Activism. I haven't quite decided yet, but I'm thinking about, you know, building up that series of paintings, and then collectively with some of the persons whose portraits I've created, that we collectively celebrate those people who are making such a difference. There is in the Boston area, and this is an international group, something called Urban Sketchers. There are a lot of informal groups that are self-organized, and Urban Sketchers Boston is one of those, where for 2 hours on every weekend, they send out a post on Instagram and say, we're meeting up at such and such, the Boston Public Library, the Harvard Museum, the Boston Common, and they meet, they go off for 2 hours and sketch or paint, then they come back together and share their work, get, you know, really learn from each other. There are open studios that are self-organized. I've taken part in most of these, and I find that not only am I learning how to paint better, but I'm now part of a community of painters, people who must draw and who must paint. And it's so I would just say that those are possibilities.